avoiding tooth decay at a time where dentists are only seeing emergencies. Hi, my name is Dr. Jeff from Bella Dental Penrith, the Penrith's most awarded dentist in the area. And today I wanted to share with you a few tips of how we could reduce the chances of getting tooth decay at a time where we're only seeing emergencies. So let's start with the basics. When we're brushing our teeth, our main objective is to get rid of plaque. Plaque, or you guys call it plaque, is the film of bacteria that forms over the teeth over a period of time. The areas that commonly get missed are in between the teeth and along the gum lines. So first, to combat the gum line issue, it's a matter of getting that toothbrush to brush towards the gums, sweeping it back and forth with short strokes, and ensuring that you've actually spent at least a minimum of 2 minutes. Normally, the electric toothbrushes have timers that tell you when you've actually done enough, but quite often, most people are not brushing long enough. Then we've got the use of dental floss. Now, a lot of people find that using the dental floss can be quite cumbersome. I've been flossing for a good 15 years, so I know what I'm doing with the floss. However, for many people, this is a very difficult feat to do. So I'm so glad that they've got these little, I call them hockey sticks because I'm from Canada, but these little flossettes, and they quite easily fit in between the teeth like so. Where's that little gap? Like so, all right? And what you want to be able to do is have it go underneath the gums, which is where all the disease-causing plaque bacteria are hiding. Now, if you're a bit older like myself and the gums have receded to create what's called a space in the embrasure, then what you can also use are these little things called pixters. Let's see if that actually focuses. Essentially, it's a tiny little brush on a stick that could fit quite easily into these spaces and clean off all the bacteria that hide right in there. So those are three tips and tools that you can use to keep that plaque away and control the disease and reduce your risk of tooth decay. Now that's the first step. Second step is snacking. I had a patient who was a bit younger than me, and she was in her 30s. Her teeth were just horrible. There are fillings everywhere, and every time I saw her, there was a new cavity. Of course, she says she brushes all day, and she says she ate healthy, and she was actually a teacher. And I was just so amused when one of her students dobbed her in. Oh yeah, Miss So-and-so is always drinking Coke. There's always a can of Coke on her desk. I was thinking, no wonder. She's a frequent snacker. And people that this is the most affected would be people that snack. People, tradies that are snacking on the job with a bottle of Gatorade or V or any sort of acidic thing. People with office jobs that are sitting behind a desk sipping on something. And the worst would be the gamers that are, you know, playing late in the night with their headsets on, sipping on that energy drink throughout the night. And so those frequent sips of snacks and acidic drinks absolutely cause the tooth decay. Now, third thing I wanted to go over was what constitutes a dental emergency, all right? So I've had people asking me, oh, I want to get my teeth checked and cleaned. That, unfortunately, is not an emergency, and we're not permitted to be doing that kind of stuff. Oh, I've had some fillings that I've needed to get done. If anything doesn't hurt, well, that can certainly wait. And for my patients that are currently in orthodontic treatment and they're waiting to get their wires changed or having adjustments done, I'm really sorry, that's going to have to wait. Now, things that do constitute for emergencies would be your toothaches, things that have been kind of hurting but are getting worse, absolutely. Then we've also got orthodontic emergencies. If there's wires poking at cheeks, causing trauma, causing pain, by all means, yes, that constitutes as an emergency. And lastly, if there's any swelling in the gums, swelling in the face, things that aren't supposed to be there, swelling in the throat, swelling in the neck, not good. If any of that is happening, please pick up the phone, give us a call, 473-3600, and we'll get yourself booked. So hopefully you guys are staying safe during this COVID-19 pandemic times. Keep those teeth clean and practice great snacking habits. Water instead of Coke, and instead of like sugary snacks, go for some nuts, pecans, pistachios, That's much better for your overall health, anyways. So, this is Dr. Jeff. Hopefully, those tips were helpful for you. I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye-bye.